Ladies and gents, welcome, welcome. We are outside of Bethnal Green Station. And we are going to walk to Whitechapel. Today is 28th of June, 4 p.m. Cloudy weather, around 23 degrees. I'm using my new equipment to film in East London. I tried to use my old one, but to be honest, the quality was so bad. The quality is so bad for some reason. I got used to this new equipment and I can't tolerate the bad the worst quality. So I'm just gonna risk it and film there. For those that don't know, I was kind of robbed in East London in Brick Lane a few weeks ago or months ago now. So when I film in the area, I prefer to use my old equipment, but since it's not sunny, it's just very bad, literally not usable. Today is 28th, as I said, so it's first day of Eid, I believe. I don't know much about it, I just know, I think they start to celebrate today. I was filming in South Hall yesterday, so they were doing the henna paintings on their hands. So I thought, originally I wanted to go to Green Street today, since that's where a lot of action is gonna happen, but it's far away for me and I don't have much time today, so I'm gonna go to Whitechapel instead and see what we can see. Maybe nothing, maybe just rush hour. I'm okay with that. So yesterday it happened at midnight on the 27th. I bought myself a one-way ticket to Thailand, to Bangkok, in a few months' time. As I mentioned a few weeks now, that they made a spontaneous decision to go to Thailand, try to lose some weight, get fit, swim in the sea. I just want to stay here for the winter. As I said, my channel does not really perform in here in London, and I go out like crazy every day, film like stupid, and you know, I don't really get any results. So I might as well not get any views while I'm in Thailand eating mangoes for the same kind of money I would spend here for rent and everything. You know, I'll be in by the sea, by a proper beach, and eating mangoes and whatever, durian, get fit, proper fit. Because I'm not gonna lie, I don't feel the best these days after eating so much. So yeah, a little reset, you know. And I'm not saying I'm gonna stay in Thailand for the whole time. Like, I don't know how long I'm going for. I don't know where I'm going. It's the first step so that I don't pay too much for my flights. Bangkok is always a safe option. You can fly to Vietnam from there. You can fly wherever, Pakistan, wherever I decide to go. Or I might stay the whole time in Thailand and just travel around there. Who knows, who knows? And usually I would have no second thoughts about going zero. I would be extremely excited, you know. But since, you know, I haven't been to the beach for 5 years now, approximately, and obviously I've made some friendships along the way, so this time it's not so straightforward for me. I'm not as excited as I normally would be. Oh my gosh, usually I would be like, phew, everything in storage, can't wait to go. It's not the case this time because, as I said, I've made some meaningful friendships, and you know, it's never easy to leave. But the thought of English winter makes things easier, not gonna lie. Let me double check the time again. I think it was 4:11 now. That's good. Oh wow, today there is no market. Oh meow meow, you're so stupid. Look, there is nothing to film, empty streets. It's okay, I always have a backup plan. What's today? Thursday? No, it's Wednesday, isn't it? Oh, maybe 4 p.m. they have to close. Maybe that's why I'm here late. But it's okay. I always like how busy it gets around 5 p.m. So, sorry guys, can I just have a look at this? Thank you so much. Look at that, boys and girls. Lots of mangoes. I think those are mangoes. Those are coconuts, all of them. Oh, those guys were amazing, right? Now it's not as busy, it's actually quite empty, it's too early, it's around 5 p.m., 5:30, it's gonna get busier here, but the market is non-existent, guys, what's happening? Let me triple check the day, I'm pretty sure it's Wednesday, but...
That's because it assumes oil and gas they take
Yeah, it is Wednesday, 28. Big jackfruit. Sorry, I just want to see the jackfruit, guys, if I may. Thank you so much. It's third. How much is it per kilo for jackfruit?
Good price, 3.99 kilo.
So it's like £4 per kilo, yeah? Amazing. Thank you.
Nice mango, Bangladeshi.
I got mango. Wow. Thank you.
Very good.
Yeah. What about what country from India?
Bangladesh.
From Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. Oh, nice,
nice. How much is it for per box?
Today, good price £7.
£7 for box. Oh, that's good. That's very good. Listen, I'm gonna finish my stuff. I will definitely come and buy one. It's amazing price. Thank you so much. Ooh, oh my gosh! Look at that. Yeah, that is an amazing price for those mangoes, and I might come and get some and eat them for dinner to practice for Thailand, because that's precisely what I do. I buy a big bag of mangoes there, but they are so cheap there. It's not like here. You pay nothing in there. You pay £1, £2 for a bag. Look at that. Again, the light is not the best, but look how big. Everybody is so dressed up. Oh, maybe that's why there is no market. Not because it's Wednesday, but because it's Eid. That would make sense. Just a limited.
Are you a fan again?
Oh, pineapples. They look great. Nice and orange. Not like the ones in Lidl, completely green. Back up here just to show you some sweeties. Hello. Try to go to Watney Market if it's still open. I'm just gonna pass the mosque here and I'll try to go through there. Oh wow, there is some police action happening there. Let me see, let me show you. Maybe they are just patrolling. London Mosque.
No, I don't.
Feels like it's very quiet here for some reason. Compared to what I'm kind of used to. I don't come here often anymore. I used to live in the area, but somehow I just have that feeling it's a little bit quieter. Here, since I didn't like the look of that motorbike, completely covered up, you can't see a thing, so I let him pass, and only then, what's this? Or maybe there will be exit here, that would be good. Exit. Maybe there is, but I can't see it. So we are hiding here from the motorbikes. potentially snatching motorbikes. So now we are going to re-emerge on the street. We are close to Old Gate East Station, East London. Thank you. Oh guys, official warning. I hope you can hear this. I hope enough people are online by now. I won't be present on premieres as much for a few months now, since I'll have so much to do, guys. I need to organize storage, which is gonna take a while. I need to book it. I need to get insurance. I need to contact my current insurance company and find out what's going on. I have to update my phone numbers on everything, since I've got a new contract, you know, on banks and everything, in case stuff happens. I need to study for life in the UK. I don't look forward to it. It's not easy. I peeped already at the situation, how much I have to learn. It's not looking good at all. That's gonna be, not to mention I have to film almost every day. So I'm gonna be very busy. And that's just the tip. I need to pack, I need to sell my electronics, since for last, I don't know how many years, I keep on putting them back in my storage, and I just can't do it anymore. I've got a touchscreen computer that I bought in Miami, and it's just getting devaluated all the time. I should have sold it long time ago. Loads and loads. Plus, think about it. For me to post one video, yeah, I need to travel 1 hour on a hot tube or whatever to central London. I have to film for an hour, for example. I need to return back. That's three hours already gone for one video, plus expenses. Then I have to edit a little bit the video and put a title, whatever. That takes longer than you would imagine. I would say even 45 minutes, around, you know, definitely half an hour. And so many hours go into posting one video that's gonna get 2,000 views, which is absolutely nothing. Plus, if I sit an hour on the premiere when I should be doing something different, you know, again another hour into that. So to post one stupid video takes, I don't know, 5 hours of traveling, filming, editing, and then chatting on the premiere. I hope this puts things into perspective. I just can't do it. I just literally can't do it. I have no, I'm not moving absolutely with my meow meow meow. I'm not moving with my to-do list. I need to set priorities and start rock and rolling, since I don't have much time left. I've got loads of stuff at home that needs to be sorted, clothes and all sorts of stuff, so. everybody's so dressed up right now. So hopefully what I explained a little bit a few minutes ago, hopefully that puts things into perspective, how much time goes into producing one video, literally half a day, 5 hours or so. So I'll try to limit the amount of time I stay on the premieres, especially since I need to book myself and try to learn the life in the UK. I don't look forward to it. Learning about Stone Age and how much of the country was occupied by who till then, till when. Oh my gosh, guys. It's not gonna be great. What I need to find out is when I pass the UK, life in the UK exam, I'm supposed to give them my passport. The problem is I'm traveling all the time. I'm going to Prague to eat roasted duck in a few days from now, for only a few days, very short time. Then I'm going to Paris later on, and I don't rule out going somewhere else in the meantime. So I don't know if I, like, if I have to give them my passport, how long for? I need to find out somehow. They've got some nice clothes here. I'm surprised, guys. A few years ago, this was all kind of, as far as I remember, it was all kind of like the Indian saris and stuff. But look at it now. This is literally incredible beachwear, gorgeous colors. I'm very impressed by their stock. Incredible. Even here, look. I think it's gonna be too late for Watani market. I don't know if it's even on today, but at least we are in a different area, boys and girls, you know. I haven't been here in a long time, so maybe some of you will be happy to see this part of London here. I used to live in Shadwell long time ago for a few months. Best kebab. That's my friend's best kebab. Let me take a picture. £6. Watani market. As I said, it's finished. But it's okay. I've got time to kill a little bit today, so we might walk around here a little bit. That's how you spell it, in case in doubt, Watani, like that. Let me see this little park here, whatever that is. But let me give you a little look of the city's skyscrapers right there. You see gherkin, everything in one pile. Love to go to Dhaka, to Bangladesh, but not by myself, and I'm a little bit scared of the mosquitoes because there is so much water, and I've heard, you know, dengue fever. They've got mosquitoes, a lot of mosquitoes there. And I've had dengue fever already, so they don't recommend to catch it second time or third time as well. My got it the first time. I was filming kickboxing. Oh, sorry, Muay Thai in Thailand, on one of the islands. I was filming it for hours and hours. At about 5-6 p.m. I got like 100 bites on my leg, but I was just standing there with my camera like stupid filming. And then a few days later, it was a disaster. I was proper sick. Long time since I've been here. Fish and chips shops. Why can't I speak today? What's happening? I should be quiet. Everybody's so dressed up. I love it. There is overground right here. I remember when this used to be completely new and beautiful, this blue, and it looks like it was reapplied a few times since then, I'm guessing, because it still looks okay. Fire station. There is a fluffy puppy on the bicycle right here. I can see Canary Wharf in the distance. Tomorrow I'm going to test my new umbrella. I bought it yesterday in Ealing Broadway, and tomorrow is supposed to be raining. 90% chance of rain, and I'll be far, far away from London in a gorgeous area. So hopefully I'll get at least an hour or two without the rain. I don't like filming in the rain because of my equipment, you know, it's not easy at all. Like this, when I'm walking like today, I'm swapping my hands every minute because it gets heavy. And imagine if you have an umbrella that is being pulled by wind and there is nothing to swap. You have to hold an umbrella and the same equipment in the other hand. So it's exhausting, it hurts. I'm a lady. So I'm really hoping I'll get some dry spells. Looking fabulous, enjoy. So look, I'm pretty sure, yeah, this is the building where I lived before. Let's see who else lived here. Henry Perking, let's go first. Oh Jesus, I don't understand a word. Yeah, you guys read it. So yeah, I lived somewhere in one of these flats for a few months when I came back from Thailand in the past, in Gosling House. Pretty sure it was somewhere, literally where the, like in this area, somewhere here, above. So yeah, and oh, there is something written here as well. Let me zoom in on that. These dwellings. Oh my goodness, 1937. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to do that. So I officially lived in a dwelling, boys and girls. I don't think I want to go there, do I? Let me see. Let's go back to civilization, to Whitechapel. It's gonna be busy there now, I think. I literally forgot. What's the best way to get there? It's 19 minutes. My best bet is to go back. It was a great location to live here. So close to city center, DLR takes you everywhere. It was good. I could walk to Liverpool Street and places like that, you know, Tower Bridge. map. So again, for those that join later on this premiere, today is 28th of June. That means the first day of Eid, if that's how I'm supposed to say it. Or Eid starts today. I don't know. I know it's supposed to last 3 days, today, tomorrow, day after. I don't really know how they celebrate. I just read something. They sacrifice animal. I just read bits and pieces. So I just know a little bit, not much. Now we are on Sutton Street. London's skyscrapers all grouped together, you see that? You know what is good? I can't speak today. What's happening? It's not so hot anymore. Around 23 degrees now compared to, 31 a few days ago. Makes a difference. Plus cloudy. It's always good as well.
Mama, remember when I said they went a bit to the park?
where we are. I slowly turn to show you the houses here. I see everybody dressed up in the cars going somewhere. I guess they are going to be visiting their families and friends. Now we are going to turn left on Stepney Way, right here. Side. So we got a better view, no trees. Well, wow, that's red Lamborghini right there. Matte finish. Looking nice. Look at this old looking house here, called the artichoke, the old artichoke. What is it, Volvo? We've got fluffy puppies here without the fluff. Ferocious creature. So this is East London, boys and girls. We are venturing a little bit off the beaten path. They are building something in there. It's definitely looking better than a long time ago when I used to live in this area. No not many modern buildings at the time. So definitely an upgrade. Oh my gosh, what is this? Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Whitechapel area. Here is the famous pub, or infamous, let me take a picture. Thank you. time now is 5:12. That's crazy. That lady not only had completely covered face, but she still had to. She still felt like she wasn't covered enough. Oh my goodness. Now the rush hour starts. Show you, sorry guys for moving really fast, but walk-in COVID vaccination center. My goodness.
She does. And he gets very frustrated. So in Pakistan and India, they will probably spray those green vegetables with water. They always look so amazing there. It's a shame they don't do it here as well. It was completely wilted. I wouldn't buy it. They're wasting their money like that. Oh, look at the colors. Thank you. Might split this video in two. I've been filming for more than an hour now, I think. So today's 28th of June, first day of Eid. We are in Whitechapel area, East London, heading towards Liverpool Street. Now it's around, it's past 5 p.m. so rush hour should be at its finest in Liverpool Street.
Thank you.
see Fluffy Puppy on the other side. A small one. Outside of Aldgate Street Station. for you. Some lovely red sports car. Sports cars. Today is Wednesday, so it's a little bit busy here. I'm just gonna walk through a little bit and go back on track. Some of these guys are standing in water. There is something in the air. Love is in the air. I'm allergic. now it's 5:40. Someone could call this sausage fest. Oh, this is called the drift. Last time I was here at night, I called it the draft because draft. Oh my gosh, don't. It was super windy. That's what I'm trying to say. God, it's busy, guys. It's hard to show you because I don't want to be twisting the camera left, right and center. But everywhere I look, it's insane. Let me try stand here for a minute.
Thank you. it's our night.
Guys, I'm gonna end it here. I didn't like how, maybe not. Maybe let's go into pedestrian zone. The guy on the motorbike was looking back at me and was looking at me while he was on my level. So I had a weird feeling. Like he was gonna do a round and come back from behind or something. You know, I'm being paranoid. But he was definitely looking. He was definitely looking. I'll try to walk back to Liverpool Street Station, but if I see him, I'm gonna immediately put my stuff away.
Come,
I personally found.
So this is what Liverpool Street Station looks like now. As you can see, no construction that I see. Thank you.
I visit you. Did you?
And today's Wednesday, not Thursday. Pretty busy, what do you say? Minutes to 6 p.m. Wednesday evening. Let me show you my next destination, right there, toilets. I've been filming for a long time. So ladies and gents, thank you so much for watching. Please press the like button, please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Hope you are all well. Take care. See you later. Bye.